We gaan even kletsen met Leven. Hij is geboren in Nederland, opgegroeid in Californië. En naast singer en songwriter en geweldige muzikant is hij dus ook producer. En hij heeft met verschillende mensen samengewerkt, van Thundercat tot Sid van The Internet. En dus nu met Beyoncé aan haar nieuwe album Renaissance. 4 songs heeft hij geco-write en geproduced. Alien Superstar, Plastic of the Sofa, Virgo's Groove en Summer Renaissance. En ja, ik dacht, als hij toch aan Nederlander is, dan moet ik hem toch eventjes spreken. Leven Keller, good to see you. And let's start off first, because I sent you a text to Instagram and I was like, hey, do you speak Dutch by any chance? Because I know you were born in the Netherlands. And you said, well, let me tell you the story in the interview. So what's the story about you being Dutch and yeah, that?
So the story is that both my parents are musicians. And my father's in a band called Mother's Finest, and they would tour in the Netherlands a lot. And it just kind of lined up. I happened to be born while they were out there, and then they decided to stay for a little bit and then came back to the States, and I was raised out here.
Yeah. And do you feel any connection to the Netherlands at all?
Yeah, of course. My godfather and my godbrother are out there, and my godfather, rest in peace, but my godbrother's out there, and we keep in touch, and just like, you know, kind of the family that we created when I was born out there. My mom stayed with people out there that we stay in touch with, and there was somebody that was born on the same night as me that we, you know, keep in touch with that family too. So it's kind of like a chosen family out there, and also like my dad's band is definitely one of their home bases is Holland. So yeah, I feel connected for sure.
Oh, that's sure. Really, really love that. So, and now you, with your Dutch connections, we listened to the Beyoncé album and we saw your name. We were like, what? I know your music. I love your music. And I was like, how did this happen? How did you end up on the Beyoncé album?
It's honestly top secret, but I just happened to be in the right place at the right time. Uh-huh. And I was working on music and just thinking about things that I feel like she and her team were thinking about, and everything kind of aligned. Mm-hmm. And it just worked out. And I'm super grateful because I think it sounds really cool, and I'm just grateful to be a part of such a cool project.
Yeah, and was it like you just wrote some things and sent it to her, or were you actually in the studio with Beyoncé?
I can't even say.
Really?
I can't even say. The way that it happens is just incredible.
And did they make you sign something like, you can talk about this because it's a secret project? Or
of course, if I say anything, yeah, there'll be like a dart that comes through the window right here. Just hits me in the...
But how do you feel about it? Because you're on the number one album in America, at least. So how does that feel for you?
Is it not number one out there?
It's not yet, I believe, right? In the Netherlands? Not yet.
Right, not yet.
But it will be, I think.
We got to get everybody out there. Everybody out there, play that. Come on. Make it number one. But no, it feels amazing. I'm just super grateful and inspired and like, you know, I love that it's music that feels very like true to who I am as a person, and I feel very connected to it spiritually and soulfully, and the process was amazing and I learned so much. So this is just like a really amazing feeling to work super hard on something and then get the fruits of your labor, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I bet you've seen it. Plastic of the Sofa, the whole challenge with all the artists trying to do that.
Have you done it yet?
I've done it on the radio, but it didn't sound like anything.
Oh man, I gotta see that.
I will send it to you, but it was not good. But
oh, come on.
I was wondering if you would be able to take a leap and do it. You know the song very well, right?
I know it a little bit for sure.
Okay.
I like it, love it, I love you, baby, yeah, yeah, hey, hey, love you, baby.
Oh my God, that was so good. That was so good. Man.
Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, your voice. Love it so much. Hey, thank you so much. We can talk to you. Is there anything you would like to say to Sublime listeners? A sort of a shout out or something.
A shout out? I mean, check out this Renaissance. If we're not number one in Holland yet, we got to go number one out there. Come on. It's Leven. I'm working on the project. I'm representing the Netherlands. We got to make that thing go number one. Check out my music and stay tuned. I'm going to be dropping music very soon and announcing, some show dates. And I'm excited to get out there and see you guys. And yeah, thank you for taking the time. I really appreciate you guys.
Yeah, love it. Thank you for taking the time because I know
and
it's.
Put me on the spot early morning. The hardest song in the world.
I know. But you did it and it sounded great.
Come on.
So
thank you.
Thank you, really.